This is Susan Wheelbanks with BlendedInsight.com. I am a holistic and integrative healing arts practitioner, an intuitive, and an energy healer. In this podcast, I share tips, tools, and suggestions that have helped me along my path in hopes of inspiring and helping you along yours. Let's get started with today's podcast topic. We meet again. Hello, bright soul. I hope you're having a beautiful morning, evening, or afternoon, whatever time you're listening to this. Thank you for co-creating and coming together again. I so appreciate you listening to this every week and also just supporting my work. It means so much to me. And I wanted to apologize to those of you who have really tried to get a hold of me. I struggle sometimes to keep up with my YouTube comments only because I am not on social media that much and I have really made it a practice to get away from my email. I can't be on call 24/7 because I have to actually be present in my everyday life. I do work full time and I have a daughter and I've got other things that I've got to get done. I'm a team of me. I live by myself. And so I don't have family around or anyone helping. And so I'm doing the very best that I can. But the reason that I was completely out of pocket last weekend is because I was in a pranic healing class. I took some higher level classes over the weekend. Classes were 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. both Saturday and Sunday, but they went a lot longer than that, plus commute time and all those things. But I mean, it was phenomenal. I just need some time to integrate. And, you know, when you're out all weekend, have to do groceries and cleaning and all those things, working, you know, all the day-to-day stuff that we have to do. But the classes were phenomenal. I'm continually learning more ways to serve and add more tools to my energetic tool basket so that I can be assisting in the world and that I can actually raise my own vibration so I can help others do the same. I ended up taking pranic psychotherapy, which was more about psychology and helping people release and extract deeply embedded negative thought patterns and traumatic emotional energies. It was phenomenal. I loved it. I also learned pranic psychic self-defense, which was so fascinating. And in this class, I just learned ways of using pranic healing to protect myself and my loved ones from psychic attacks, negative intentions, malicious entities, energetic pollution, and all of those things. So I am just feeling really super blessed that I found the pranic healing community. I love the community. And a lot of times I'll get questions. People just think I only do Reiki. To be honest with you, I don't use Reiki as much as I used to, not in my private practice. The reason why is Reiki is great. I learned Reiki in 2011, so I've been practicing Reiki for 9 years. And I still use Reiki. I use it on my YouTube channel because I can send the energy. But what I like about pranic healing is it has clearing properties. So pranic healing it comes from the same source as Reiki, so it's not that much different, but the cleansing properties are missing from Reiki. Where Reiki just pushes the energy, which is super effective, pranic healing teaches you how to pull things out of the aura. And then you have a clean slate to fill the aura. And that's what I love about it. Plus, I have just met phenomenal people in the pranic healing community. You know, initially when I was doing this work, I developed really quickly and my energetic body couldn't keep up with my physical body. So I was experiencing this heightened sensitivity that was crippling for me. For the first time ever, I couldn't go around people who were harsh and negative, and I didn't really understand what was going on. I struggled going to get my blood drawn for the first time ever in my life. It was something about the invasive environment. I was picking up the energies of the anxiety of the people in the hospital. And I hated it. And I was just like, I don't know what to do with this. And I couldn't fix it. And so I went years upon years trying to correct this in myself. Like, why am I so sensitive? I don't like this. And what I have learned over the years is that you have to develop your spiritual maturity and your spiritual practice to then merge that gap with your physical body so you can turn it on and off. And that's really what I've been on a quest to learn. And I'm finally there. I'm not 100%, but I'm so much closer. And now I can show up and be functioning in the world and let my light influence the environment instead of the environment influencing me. So now I don't have to become as much of a hermit. And I'm going to talk about that in a later podcast. But on today's podcast, I want to talk about moving through dark times because I was in that class all weekend. Monday was a holiday, but I had jam-packed schedule because I still had to get groceries and clean house and tend to my daughter and work and all those things you have to do, even though my weekend was full, and take clients for that matter. And so I came out and I'm just getting text messages and emails and social media comments and inboxed messages through Facebook of people, help, 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 help. I got this going on, that going on. And it's like, whoa, I know I just took the class. And the energy always ups your ante when your aura gets bigger. You draw more people to help. And I want to help. But I'm like, okay, wait a minute. Let me integrate and let me look at my schedule. One of the things that I've learned through this work is I have to put the oxygen mask on myself first. Initially, it's common with healers to just heal until their physical body is nothing. You know, we fizzle ourselves out. And that's actually not health. It's not healthy. In order for me to give everything that I can give, I have to be grounded and healthy and whole. I need to have done my meditation, get my aura nice and strong and big so that the little time that I do spend is beneficial. The other thing is just know that I do a daily meditation practice. This work comes through me and not from me. Yes, I do the work to learn the skills of applied energy healing practices. And I have learned the skills to develop my intuition more and do oracle readings and all those things. But at the end of the day, this information is coming from a higher source. It's through me and not from me. And when I'm in my meditation practice, if there is someone that I need to get to sooner than what I've initially scheduled, that information will come forward and my schedule will shift around. It's very guided. And so we just have to trust that you're going to get what you need when you need it at the perfect time. And I will open myself up to be a channel during that time space. And so it's kind of, we have to flow with it. That's all I can say. When you open yourself up to be an instrument of service to the world, you're open and you have to trust. And so I'm asking you to do the same. So let's move on with today's topic. The common theme that I've heard this week is why? I've done all of the work. I'm trying my very best to be a beneficial presence on the planet. I felt like things were going to come through and they didn't. So now I'm sad, angry, scared, all of the emotions that we experience. And so what I want to share, first of all, is when I do energy healing and intuitive work with people, or I get it for myself, everything exists in energetic potential. We have free will choice to make decisions, to shift, to move and change. So we could do energy work together and we could hang up and then something shifts within you and the outcome shifts. This has happened in my life. So this is part of it. And the reason that I'd like to get readings is because I like to see exactly what's around me so that I know whether or not I'm on the right path or the path that I would desire, or if I need to shift some things. I get energy healing so that I can be a clear channel to receive the information and function at my highest level. Everyone's energy field gets dirty on some level at some point. There isn't a soul walking around that's in the world that just walks around with a full, clean aura 100% of the time. It just isn't, it's possible, but it's not probable in the world that we're in. So that's why doing a daily meditation practice, you know, in pranic healing, their version of a loving kindness meditation is called a meditation on twin hearts, where you send love out into the planet. And so it cleans your aura. When you're sending out love and positive energy, you're raising your own vibration and you're sending out that vibration to the world or to someone else. So it helps to naturally clean you. Also, you know, exercise cleans out your health rays. Your health rays are kind of like that first line of defense of things sticking to your aura. If you're pushing energy out, things that were stuck on the outside of your aura, like negative thought forms and just yucky energy, it pushes off. So without me ever really even knowing that on a practical level, I just knew that when I was feeling stuck energetically, and I exercised, I felt better. So for me, I knew it was important before I knew about the health rays. Also, doing service to others opens up your heart chakra and it helps to create good karma. So it kind of keeps things in perspective and it helps you to realize how blessed you are and how we're here to help one another. And so here is what I've learned through my dark nights of the soul, and I've had a lot of them. I've had, you know, times where I was unemployed and had a baby, another mouth to feed, and was worried about being able to provide, working, where to live. You know, I've lost people close to me, tremendous loss. I've had narcissistic relationships, people that have taken from me. I've started over so many times, all the way over, where I've worked really hard, built things up, and then partnered with someone who took everything, or it was just a loss that I was willing to just let go of. And, you know, I had a very traumatic childhood, like experiences in childhood. My parents did the very best they could, but it just wasn't what I needed on a physical level. My soul knew exactly what I needed. And so I understand hardships. I really do understand hardships. And we all have our own stories. And so it's not in an attempt to get in competition with people. I don't know if you've ever had the experience of sitting with someone and sharing something that's hard for you, and they try to one-up you with their hardship. That's not the game I'm playing here. And you know what? In my earlier years, not knowing it better, I know I've done that, where people are like, oh my gosh, I'm so busy and I have this. And I'm listening to them, and I can't help but to make a mental note of all of the ways in which I've got 10 times more than that going on. So that's just part of the human condition and the ego. But here is what I have learned and what I know to be true. If I didn't experience those dark nights, I wouldn't be who I am today. And here's why. When things are cruising along perfectly, we have no incentive to learn something new or grow. When you are experiencing fear and tremendous heartache and grief, these are the times when you really get to know yourself. You get to know an intimate part of yourself that you won't know when things are just floating along and rosy and gorgeous and there is no issue. Another thing is, when things are going great, we have the tendency, I'm not going to speak for you, but I'll speak for myself and many people that I know, we have the tendency, me and my higher self, that's what I mean by we, to slack off on our personal growth or our spiritual development because things are going well. But when you get that rug yanked out from underneath your feet, you're looking for something to pull you up. And those are the times when it's like, okay, I need to meditate. I need to learn. How can I shift this? Maybe I now need to get an energy healing. Maybe now I need to go to a spiritual temple, or I need something to help me because I feel like I'm drowning. I'm afraid. And so those are the times when you deepen your spiritual practice. Those are the times when you experience shifts, major shifts, and you experience enlightenment if you choose. I would not have got on, I wouldn't be on the path that I'm on if I hadn't had felt as though I needed some type of mentor in my life, and it couldn't have been physical because I just didn't have that growing up. So I was reaching out to find a new way to parent my child, find a new way to live, because what I was doing, it wasn't working. And so that's how we learn. It's incentive to learn. And the soul, your higher soul, is looking for ways to advance you. Because whatever you learn in this life, it's going to go with you. This body may die. If you don't believe in multiple lives, then that's okay. Just ignore this part. But for me, it only makes sense to me that our souls live in eternity. We live and live and live. And the body dies off, but the soul moves on. And so for me, that's what makes sense to me. It took me a long time to understand that. Growing up, I didn't. But I do believe that now. And if you don't believe it, I completely respect that. And I respect your views. So please don't leave me any ugly comments. I will just delete it. And I've learned through my psychic self-defense, when you lodge hate and negativity toward people who are on a spiritual path, your karma tends to materialize quicker. Negative karma. Whatever you put out, it comes back to you. So don't do that. Or unless you just want the negative karma, then be my guest. That's also a lesson for me. The higher you get in your spiritual development, the more powerful your energy becomes and the faster your karma comes back. That's why you have to be really careful about what you say and what you do. As you grow, even in school, when you're in kindergarten, you get away with more because you're still learning and everyone understands you're still learning. But when you're in high school, now you have consequences because you should know better. And it's the same way as your soul develops and you get on the spiritual path. You know, when I'm learning all these deep energy healing tactics and all of this beautiful work designed to help people, you know, I could use it for negative, but I will suffer the consequences that much quicker. And I would never do that. One of the things that I really enjoyed in Pranic Healing is, like, they were calling us white magicians because there are black magicians, people that do things for harm, but we come from the lineage of compassion. So we use our tools to help people. And even those that are harmful, we know when they try to harm us, their karma is going to materialize quicker and more fiercely. So we allow them to do that because that's what their soul is working out. But we don't lash out. We don't go back. And so that's kind of where you are right now. If you're on a deep and dark path right now, what it feels like it's a dark path because you're going through some challenges. So this is an opportunity to deepen your spiritual practice. This is an opportunity to face those things that maybe you thought you worked out and now they're up again. Sometimes healing goes in layers. You think you've learned a lesson and then here it comes again and you get frustrated. I mean, I've had this where I'm like, dang, I thought I healed that already and here it is again. There's another layer that's coming up to be cleared. And so it's an opportunity. You have to shift your perspective. It's not that you're a victim. It's an opportunity to look at things a different way. It's an opportunity to shift and grow. If you think about it, all great spiritual teachers or just teachers in general, most of them didn't get to this level without receiving some type of tragedy that they had to transform and make the best of. All of the most inspirational teachers that I have personally listened to and resonated with and follow, they came from really humble beginnings or everything was good and then they hit a massive pothole and they had to climb their way out. This is how we grow. So instead of feeling like a victim and feeling like things aren't going to get better, shift it and say, wait a minute, what is this here to help me learn? I know I'll get through it because I've been through other things and I've made it through. I can come out of this with a higher level of peace, success, abundance, well-being. I'm going to learn something from this. I'm going to extract the gems. That's what I've always done and it's helped me. And I always know if I start to get a little bit complacent, it's that memory comes up where, whoop, don't get complacent because your higher soul is going to throw something at you to make you deepen your spiritual practice so that you can go a level deeper. And so that's why it's important if you can commit to a spiritual practice and keep up with it. And in my darkest times in the early days where I just really had no direction, I felt really lost. I didn't have anyone in my family that was on this path or open to it. More or less had people that were trying to pull me back instead of looking forward, and no one really understood where I was at or my individual circumstances or my vision. I was very alone. And those were the times where I really went and dug really deep within, looking for the lessons, the gems, and asking the source, you know, the universe, to help me find a way. And those are the times when I became more open that I was led to information that helped me. And then later down the line is when I learned about energy healing and I was able to work with a private practitioner. We always find what we need if we're open to it. So I would just really encourage you, if you feel really down, you can get on the internet and look for inspirational talks and teachers and people who have overcome tremendous hardships and let that inspire you. We're so saturated with information now, and it's really easy now to go out and find something to help you shift and continue to grow and move. What I mentioned before and what was even, you know, reiterated in my pranic healing training this weekend is that to develop your soul and to develop your physical body, exercise, meditation, and service. And if you feel as though, oh, I don't have the money, serve with your hands. Volunteer. If you don't feel like you have the time, find a way to serve. One way that everyone can serve is by doing a loving kindness meditation. Meditation on Twin Hearts, there's variations on the internet that are free. There's also downloads you can get on iTunes. I also have loving kindness meditations for free on my YouTube channel. So there are all kinds of ways. It's just, what are you willing to do? What are you willing to commit to move yourself out of this, to grow to the next level, and to continue to be a light on this planet? So I would just invite you to shift your perspective and know that growth is a process. We have to get uncomfortable in order to grow to the next level. It happens to all of us. It's not just you. And I know sometimes we feel like, oh my gosh, this is just me, my life. No, there's billions of people on the planet. And I can guarantee you there's people that are going through exactly what you're going through. Maybe even worse things, maybe better things. The point is we're all here because we are in the process of development. And we each come in at different levels. We each come in with different missions. And so the point is to develop in the way that your soul most needs and to be a beneficial presence. Let's create good karma. Let's help others. Let's, you know, be together in a community and help each other through times, because that's what really matters. And at the end of the day, when I think about all the times in which I was going through really rough times, what meant the most to me is people who encouraged me, people who spoke a word that I really needed that resonated. And this could be people that I don't know personally, but that I resonate with and listen to. You know, it's those moments of kindness when you really need it that goes a long way. And we all have the capability of doing that to other people and with other people. You know, you may not have the resources right now to help another person, but you can speak a kind word. You can send loving, healing energy that they feel that resonates with them. And it doesn't have to be from a effort. It has to be more from just allowing it to flow through. Human connection, it's important. So let's do a healing. Go ahead and uncross your arms and legs. And for this healing, I will be working on clearing out stress energy first. So just focus on your breathing and receive. Doing some shields on you and filling your aura with healing energy. Okay, and so it is. So come back into your body. Might want to take a couple of deep breaths. Make sure you drink a little bit of extra water today. You know, days, months, years from now, you'll look back at this very space-time in your life and think, wow, that was difficult. But gosh, I got so much out of that. It was a pivotal time in my life. I moved through it and I'm thankful for that. When we're in it, it's hard to say, oh gosh, I'm so thankful for this. But it's after we move through it, we can look back and go, okay, that was really good. That really did help me develop in many ways. And so let's just focus on positive outcomes and what we can get out of this time. Know that you're not alone. Many people are experiencing the very same thing you are, and we will all move through it collectively. You can make it. You've been through worse. You're in it now. You're moving through it. You're not stuck. So just keep on moving. Do some meditation. Do some exercise. Do some service. That will help you boost your will centers, increase your positive karma, and help you to move through it a little bit easier, even though I know it's tough. If you're not subscribed to my YouTube channel, get on over to YouTube, Blended Insight, and subscribe, where I post a new healing every week. You can get on my newsletter, blendedinsight.com, right on the front, subscribe to my newsletter. And if you're looking for healings, subscribe to my newsletter. I feel like I say that 1,000 times. If you subscribe to my newsletter, you can receive a free healing download by topic. I just do not have the time to go back and grab healings and send direct links to people. I'm only one person, and I've created so many, I can't remember them all. So it's best to just help yourself. Get on that mailing list, get that list and look for yourself, or just trust what you're drawn to. And if you don't mind, leave me a review on iTunes. I would so appreciate it. I hope you have a beautiful week. Take care. Bye-bye.